I'd already been out to my first Weiser, went out in 77.
He would always tell me about this thing called Weiser. I would say, well, what's it like? I'd say, well, no, just kind of have to find out for yourself. You have to see it. I can't explain it.
Walter, tell us what's going on here.
We're on our way to Weiser, Idaho.
We're on our way to the greatest living hell there could possibly be. It's going to be a week of absolute torture. Walter, why did I let you take me? Why did I let you do this?
Weezer is the ultimate West Coast old-time party.
And I had heard about Weezer. I didn't really know what it was.
Greg Clark would set me up with great tapes he made at Weezer. He'd come back from Weezer with this box of tapes.
It sounded exciting, and Matt wanted to go, and he found out that Dave Pugh was driving out there, and so he lined up a ride with Dave Pugh, and then I decided I wanted to go too and check out this fiddle festival.
The first time I went to Weezer, I think there was four people playing in Stickerville, and they were playing a Valley Forge, an old fiddle tune, you know. And it's kind of crooked. And it just grabbed me, you know. Like, I hadn't been grabbed in years. I
set up our camps, and then we just joined in this one little jam. That was my first experience with actual communities of people sitting around playing old-time music.
The more that I got to know those people, the more I felt this bond between us, but I didn't ever discover what exactly it was until I started going to Weezer.
I started going to Weezer to learn the old tunes. I'd go that far to usually hang out with people from Portland.
And then I got to Weezer, I'm like, oh my God, is everybody at Weezer?
That was my first Weezer. That summer, me and Taylor and Caleb drove out there together, and that really kind of started to get bond between all of us. And then that next fall, we started up Foghorn Leghorn.
I first heard about Weezer when I was up in Port Townsend, Washington, being a bum sneaking in the back door, and I met Walter Spencer there, and everybody just got back from Weezer, and he told me what a great time everybody had.
Well, just imagine going out into the middle of nowhere and camping behind some semi-abandoned buildings in a sticker field and baking in the heat. You know?
You put sheets down to cover they keep you shielded from the brutal sun. It's like 110 degrees there sometimes.
Pulled up in that sticker-laden little area with everybody playing their fiddles and banjos, and it was pretty darn incredible.
It's just so laid back. No worries.
And I remember watching Clancy playing his fiddle and singing, and he fell over backwards, and I heard a big pop. He landed on my friend Tony Wright's fiddle and broke it in five different pieces.
Yeah, there comes busting through the sheets, laughing and stuff, and just falls right down.
Play some more tunes, eat some more, have something to drink. Play some more tunes, have a little more something to drink.
Now, Weezer, that was something fun. I've been to a lot of festivals before, but boy, Weezer is just a scene.
You know, Weezer functions on so many levels, it's great.
I mean, I love hanging out with people that are into this music. I mean, you have that much in connection with them, and it doesn't matter where they're from, and they're playing the tunes, and the tunes are getting passed on, and people are doing their own thing with them. And
I had a big breakthrough this year at Weezer.
I remember getting dirty looks when I got really excited about, you know, getting it after.
We were joking that it was going to be the summer of love at Weezer, and it kind of was the summer of love. It was like this just incredible feeling of all of these people all together who just love each other so much, and you just didn't matter who you were picking with, because it was all just, everyone just loved each other.
And then I was sitting with Michael Dickel, and Rachel and Josh Cole, and they gave me some special tea, and the rest of the evening was really fun.
It just opened up my eyes to how to listen as a musician in a way I never understood before. It was an awesome experience. But this year at Weiser meant that I felt comfortable sitting on the two jams, so that was really great.
Weezer's, that's what got me hooked, I guess, you know, because at the end of Weiser, after about a week of doing that every day and night, I kind of felt like I had a better handle on it.
Probably a lot more fun to come to Weezer and hang out with these jokers and play music than it would have been to go and hang out with, I don't know, well, I bet hanging out with the Skill Lickers probably would have been pretty fun.
I take this highly accurate template that I made off of Taylor Grover's old Dobson at Weezer.
Oh, you get that big buzz going. Everybody's kind of playing and it just sort of kind of rolls around itself.
So I went to Weezer and really played tunes there for the first time.
Festival on the West Coast.
So I met everybody in Portland at Weezer, and
my first experience in Portland, or with Portland community, was actually in the state of Idaho at the Weezer.
There were these women from California camped on the other side of the field from where we camped, and they seemed to be having a lot of fun. It was Maggie and Amy and Barb Hanson.
Barb gets to go drive 5 hours to a desert to sit in the field and play tunes all night. And it's really fun.
That was a real bonding experience for all of us, I think.
When they're playing that way, their mind is going into some different space. And involved in this kind of music and to be in this community, I just really feel fortunate. When I leave Weezer, I just feel so lucky.
But I don't know, it's a cool banjo. It sounds the best at Weezer.
But I had a blast that first Weezer, right?
What kind of music is this?
The sun went down and the moon came up and everything got real loud.
Some of the first really exciting musical experiences for me was just being part of a throb jam.
And then I wander over to Stickerville and see these old time sessions and walk out into a dark field, totally dark, and a little circle, and all these people just hovering around. You can't even see their faces, and they're just this little throb of old time music coming out of it. And I thought it was very cool.
The words just start emanating instantly. The moment I think of throb, thousands upon thousands of words just start gushing out of my mouth. But I hold them back out of sheer restraint.
Throb is a beautiful flower.
You were feeling it and you were in the moment and playing your heart out.
It was just this huge gang. Everybody camped out.
But basically the throb was a large, undulating mass.
It was ridiculous.
We organized a party that winter and called it Throbfest.